With Detective Chris Serino back on the witness stand, the prosecutor zeroed in on George Zimmerman's language.
They always get away.
While describing Trayvon Martin to the police.
Calling somebody, reference them as, part of my language, punks.
That is ill will and spite.
Prosecutors must prove ill will, spite, or a depraved mind to get a conviction for second-degree murder. Serino was a prosecution witness, but some of his testimony seemed to bolster the defense. Prosecutors started the day trying to undo the damage. In earlier testimony, the detective said he found Zimmerman's story to be credible. The prosecution convinced the judge to strike that from the record. The judge called it an improper comment. The prosecution tried instead to focus Serino on inconsistencies in Zimmerman's story about his confrontation with the unarmed teenager. But under cross-examination, Serino said the defendant stuck to his original account.
He was, in fact, consistent throughout, correct?
Yes, he was.
Next on the stand was Mark Osterman, who described Zimmerman as the best friend he ever had. He described Zimmerman's version of events on that February night last year.
George said Trayvon grabbed his head and started bashing his head on the concrete.
The medical examiner described the injuries as insignificant.
They were not life-threatening. They were very insignificant.
Zimmerman has pleaded not guilty, claiming self-defense. Susan McGinnis, CBS News, Sanford, Florida.